Brian Murphy from Cork, Shane O'Neill from Cork, they were all there, but I think, you know, Jackie Turl, I think, was head and shoulders, both physically and hurling wise over everybody. And, you know, I think he was the automatic choice for number four, as was the right half back, which finishes me, I suppose, right half back. You know, Tommy Walsh, you know, fantastic. You know, it was Willie O'Connor said the other night, I think somebody said that Paddy Walsh will be even better than Tommy. And he said, how could you be even better than Tommy? So, you know, he has it an excellent year again. And, you know, no betting that Tommy Walsh wasn't going to make that fantastic year for him as well.
All right, then. Pete will carry on the selection. Centre half back, Pete.
Yeah, at the beginning of the year, we're expecting that Davey would pick Ken McGrath at centre back. But surprisingly, he put Michael Walsh back there, and he had a fantastic year. He had a great Munster campaign. Solid physical player, brings great presence to the game. Ronan Corran, I thought, had an outstanding year as well. Right. And in fairness, Tony O'Gregan, he silenced an awful lot of critics in Galway. JJ Delaney, with Noel Hickey back, he was back in his favourite position. An outstanding wing back. Pádraig Maher had a fantastic game today, but JJ had a little bit more done throughout the year, and he deserved the nod ahead of him. Brendan Maher played wing back last year. He's midfield this year. He was a brilliant minor. He was probably the best minor that I ever saw, and he's brought that forward into senior level now as well, and he's outstanding. Deserves his call. Michael Finnerty is his partner in midfield. Powerhouse in the middle of the field. Covers every blade of the pitch when he's playing. His contribution from scores as well is incredible. Fantastic hurler. Right. Might be the biggest man on the field, but number 10 is Damien Hayes. Another player with a great engine, had a great league campaign, was Galway's most consistent forward in the Leinster campaign, and deserves the nod at right half forward.
Good, you got as far as with your voice. Number 11, Michael Duignan.
Yeah, number 11, I think this man's position at centre forward is probably the main reason that Tipperary won the All-Ireland. Noel McGrath, you know, he went out there against Waterford, masterstruck by the management. And when you see him playing centre forward with his vision, we saw against Waterford his accuracy, 5 points, but his vision brings other players into the game. Brilliant pass today for Lara Corbett's goal, and it's really the ideal position for him, and a brilliant year.
At number, you had to juggle around a few positions in the attack.
Yeah, well, we said juggle around the way Tipperary played this year. Like Lara Corbett, we've picked at 12. We could have picked him in a lot of different positions, but you know, he moves around all over the place, and he had just a fantastic year. And to score 3 goals in an Ireland final is just an unbelievable achievement. And you know, it hasn't been done for. We're trying to figure out. We think 1966 was the last time it was done in an Ireland final. So brilliant, and again, a brilliant career with Tipperary over the last 10 years. At 13. Is one of my, I'd have to admit, one of my favourite players of all time, Eoin Kelly from Tipperary, the captain. Last year he gave one of the greatest performances I've ever seen in Ireland final. He didn't make the team, I think, and he didn't make the All-Stars. He slipped at a vital time, he scored 13 points, but this year, carrying a very serious back injury, scored 2 great goals against Waterford and showed the leadership today, took all the frees and put them over, and well deserved. At 14, Richie Power really became the leader of the Kilkenny team in the semi-final when Henry Shefflin went off. Had a very, very, very good year, took his goal well today and scored you know, a lot of good frees as well. And in the other corner, I think an automatic, John Milan from Waterford, had a fantastic year. Probably the most free scoring forward from play. I think he is the most free. He's the highest scorer from play of the current crop of players. And he had another great year for Waterford.
All right then, so that's the team completed. Of what, 7 from Tipperary, 5 from Kilkenny, 2 from Waterford, and 1 from Galway. That's our panel, Sunday game, Team of the Year for 2010. I'm sure there's lots of different views and opinions. So I wonder, Damien Fitzhenry, maybe any player you consider unlucky to lose out when you look at that?
Yeah, probably the two I would see unlucky to lose out would probably be Noel Connors from Waterford. Thought he had a fantastic year this year, Connor back, and probably Pádraig Maher. You know, who epitomised the Tipperary, the hunger today with his performance today. And I suppose he'd hurled well throughout the year as well.
Sure. Johnny Dooley?
Yeah, I suppose similar to Damien. I suppose other than that, there's not an awful lot of omissions. You know, them two guys in particular, I suppose Cork might be wondering why they have maybe nobody on it either. You know, they got to the semi-final, but it's hard to argue with the team outside of the two guys that Damien has mentioned.
Yeah, Shane Dooley didn't get in, but he had a very good year. He finished second highest scorer in the championship.
Yeah, he was just pipped by Eoin Kelly by 2 points. He had a very good year. Yeah. He didn't, did you?
No shame to lose out to Eoin Kelly, I suppose.
No.
Fergal Hartley, can I ask you for your views on it?
Yeah, I'd agree with the two lads. Pádraig Maher would be the one I think is probably the most obvious one that's missing. Yeah. And would agree Noel Connors. And as you say, Shane Dooley as well. You know, I think Shane Dooley had a fantastic year, so they'll be the main two or three.
Okay. The selectors are getting away reasonably well here. Johnny Henderson, what do you think?
Well, there's not many teams that I wouldn't pick Joe Canning on, and I still think he was good enough to make it somewhere on that forward line this year. I'd say overall, Kilkenny would be happy with what they got. I think the two halfbacks had a fantastic year, even though Pádraig Maher did lose out to it, but it's great to be mentioned in the same company.
Right, OK. Ollie Canning, apart from Joe not being selected and Ollie not being selected, anything else in the team there that strikes you?
Well, I mean, it throws up debate every year, but I mean, myself, losing out to Jackie there in the corner, you know, he's had a fantastic year and all the rest of it. But, like, you know, it's important, I suppose. There's a couple of lads juggled around in different positions, but if they are the best hurlers, I think they should get on the team, you know what I mean?
And are they the best?
yeah, I mean, it's, look, there's certain guys will have different, you know, good games and you know, at different stages of the year, but it's hard to argue with that, really, you know what I mean? They're all fine hurlers there, you know.
Yeah, Len Gaynor?
Yeah, well, I suppose Donal O'Grady won't be recalled as Cork manager, I'd say. He's no Cork man on the team there, so...
He did his best, I can tell you.
Yeah, I bet you he did, yeah. I'm sure he did.
Well, I mean, so,
I'm surprised that Pádraig Maher isn't on, really. You know, I think a fine, powerful hurler, powerful young player, and, you know, I thought he should have made it, but that's the way.
But, yeah, but JJ Delaney is a hell of a player as well, which is probably...
Can't argue with that.
...why the debates are going on. All right, thanks, Len. All right, then, man of the match. We've had a few names thrown out. Lar Corbett's three goals thrown out. Dinny made the case, of course, that there are defenders as well and midfielders. Michael?
Yeah, well, you know, we looked... Tipperary really had... Michael Fennelly was the one from Kenny. He didn't get into our top three, but really it was Tipperary we were looking at, and it was a great team effort today. But Lar Corbett is one of our nominees. He had a fantastic game, as I said, scoring the three goals. Pádraig Maher, who the lads mentioned, I would agree. I think Pádraig Maher had a better game today than JJ Delaney, but I think over the year maybe JJ shaded it. But Pádraig Maher had a fantastic game, and he's such a young player, powerful man, and great hurler. Right. And particularly at centre back, I think when he went in there. And we also went for Noel McGrath as a nominee. Brilliant vision. I think he's passed for the goal for Lara, and a couple of point ones. And he was, you know, he's great work rate as well around centre half forward. So they're the three that we went with.
OK, so they're the three nominees. Let's head back then to Michael at the team hotel. I'm sure there's great excitement. And Michael, you can tell us who is our Sunday game man of the match.
Yeah, it is. You can be sure of it. There is great excitement and there's great anticipation about the announcement as well. So, as they say, without further ado, let me tell you that. Well, they say, and the cliche has it, that goals win matches. He got three today. From Thurles Sarsfields, our man of the match is Lar Corbett. Yeah, that indeed is our man of the match for the 2010 All-Ireland Final, Lar Corbett. Now, Christy Cooney, the president of the GAA, is here with us to make the presentation. Christy, would you please do the honours? Lar, on our panel today on the programme, Cyril Farrell, Tomás Mulcahy and Gerlach Nan were saying before the match, you know, what Tip have to do is keep Lar Corbett in close to that goal in there because he'll get goal chances. You must have had a telly on the dressing room, did you?
Sure. I suppose at the end of the day, it's great to get the win here. And I suppose what it comes down to is the work rate of everyone else on the field here today. And that's what it comes down to. Like, you know, when I was speaking to the boys after the match, like, if you saw the pass Noel McGrath gave for the second goal, there's not too many players in hurling that give passes like that. Like, you know, he's back to the player. And that's what it comes down to. Like, you know. And I suppose for the third one there, Bonner Mayer, what he does best, he got a ball he shouldn't have got. He was on the flat of his back. He got up, hand pass out. And it makes everyone else's job that bit easier. Like, you know, when the work is done, the boy's done the hard work. I was lucky enough to be at the end of him. Like, you know, that's what it comes down to.
Now, one of the things, like some of the other players that are on the tape team today, like Brendan Cummins, you were talking to earlier on, and Eoin Kelly, of course, you are one of the players that was there in 2001. So I suppose after 9 years, this is also very sweet.
It is. It's extra special, I suppose. In 2001, I was probably on a, like, you know, we were probably on a vibe that we didn't really know what it was all about, even winning in 2001. Didn't really know exactly what it took to win an All-Ireland. We were lucky enough at the time. And I suppose in the last 7 or 8 years there, the work that has gone in has been unbelievable. And it makes it extra special when you see the years have slipped by. But delighted to be here now tonight in front of all these people, like, you know, and a great win.
All right, now let me just bring in Christy Cooney. Christy, I'm sure you want to add your congratulations to Tip's win today.
Today was a phenomenal day for our association. Spectacular game. Kilkenny going for 5 in a row, but Tipperary fairly vanquished that today with an outstanding performance. And very worthy All-Ireland champions today. So sincere congratulations to the backroom team, to the county board and to the players in particular for the great performance they gave us today.
Oh, it was a fantastic match and we all enjoyed it. Thanks, Christy. Now, I do have one other very, very pleasant task to perform, because as well as receiving the Man of the Match trophy from today's game, Etihad Airways, of course, are one of the sponsors, as you know, of the Hurling Championship, have given us 2 return flight tickets to any of their destinations around the world. So you're off with your holidays there. And myself and Christy are available to go and mind you, by the way, on the trip as well. Our man of the match in the 2010 final, Lark Corbett. Congratulations again, Lark. Congratulations, well. Dad, it's back to you.
Okay. Well done, thanks, Michael. Well, congratulations indeed to Lark Corbett. Fantastic. Well, that's about it. The party will go on there. Thanks very much to Michael, Donal and Pete for joining us, and especially to all of our special audience who joined us here tonight and added so much. Delighted to have them. Sincere thanks to also the team here in the programme who's put together tonight's hectic programme. And congratulations again to Tipperary and the Miners of Kilkenny. And our thoughts are not gone from Kilkenny and the Clare Miners, who made a great day for all of us. But as we pay our respects to the worthy winners, it wouldn't be right to sign off without saying well done to Brian Cody and his squad and what's been a magnificent few years. Good night. Some bruises, 12 mates banging on the door, oh, the back of Pennsylvania, I never saw such a street.